The ceilings are roughly, I think, like, when we get back up here, they're roughly, I think, 30 feet.
Ah. Damn, there we go.
Yeah. Obviously, in terms of kind of the offices and the,
yeah.
We'll kind of get to the root of it, like, back here.
Turn my music high, 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 yeah.
You don't know what you're doing.
Sure I do. I'm from the streets where the hood swallow on me. Bullets are following me. There's so much coke that you can run the slalom.
So I don't know what's load bearing and what's not.
Yeah.
Something we'll have to kind of do some due diligence on.
Yeah.
But my assumption is all this could kind of be knocked out.
Yeah.
And opened up. The ceilings are roughly, I think, like, when we get back up here, they're roughly, I think, 30 feet.
Ah. Damn, there we go.
Yeah.
So in the open area, it's about 30 feet, and where there's a second floor, I would say it's about, what, 16?
Yeah, roughly.
How do you typically, like, how do you structure
Chamonix when you're dealing with Chamonix?
Got a year rent free to build, and then you get half rent in year two, and then, these bigger spaces, they're really hard to lease, you know, because you need a single tenant.
Yeah.
There we got a clip, yeah, we're paying $500,000 a year in rent. The space as is, we're having to spend like $20-22 million on our build out. And so we have 1 year rent free on the day we sign a lease, 1 year half rent, so it's about $240,000 in rent, and then the following year it's $40,000, 3% increase per annum. We did a 12-year deal, 4 or 5 year options.
Okay.
Our deals, because we're not putting money into it.
Yeah, I mean, Every landlord loves the deal that they have to invest capital in. Yeah, so the total, like, square footage is roughly 76,000.
On one floor?
On two.
On two.
So we'll go upstairs.
It's a bit bigger. You want to show us the Christmas tree shop too?
Yeah, we can look
at that.
The ceiling heights there are going to be a little bit lower, obviously, compared to this.
Like 16, 20?
They're, I think, roughly like 20-ish.
So this is 70,000, you said?
Yeah, 76, roughly. 120,000. They have indoor fields and stuff like that.
Cool.
So
we'll go on House of what?
House of Sport. Mm-hmm. So that, you know, the customer basically try on, like, the cleats, use them on a field.
Oh, that's cool.
Try the equipment. Yeah, so it's a, like, full experience shopping.
Yeah, I've seen that at some other ones. They have virtual golf, so you can practice the club.
Yep.
Things like that. Yeah.
It's gonna be that kind of, like, try everything. Like,
try before you buy it.
Exactly.
That's cool.
So, like you just said, they ran into some issues, but October opening, yep. And they should be doing that. It's about 120 square feet.
I think 100,000.
Yeah.
And then 20,000 square feet of putting room.
What's your membership?
Well, that location would be more of a flagship.
Okay.
That would be $99.
Okay.
And our typical gym is like $69.
That's still competitive for the market.
Yeah.
I mean, for a higher end.
Yeah, the goal is to make them an offer so good they feel dumb saying no. Right? So, but everyone tries to add as much as possible, see how much they can charge. We try to add as much as possible, see how little we can charge.
And that's all the way through down that way. And then there's another room that gets 21 by 29 feet over there.
Okay.
And over in the other offices, and there's another corridor, 7 feet wide and like 70 feet long. Over here, 18 feet.
Mm-hmm.
And then inside the space is like 16 feet.
Ah. This.
So Christmas tree shop was 48. This is 25. So you can combine the two.
Thank you, sir.
Yep.
Yep, move.
Yeah.
Blow everything out.
Yeah.
And I'll show you what the unfinished space would look like. And all the walls are in there.
If they're not here, we get rid of it.
Yeah.
Your sign right here. So if these spots are taken here and you end up parking in that lot right there, again, there's plenty of parking, and it's not that far.
Yeah.
Right. And you could orient your space starting down that corner, down at this corner, or in the middle.
Yeah.
So it's really a blank slate.
Yeah.
Is there any one large tenant in this building?
Pep Boys. It's on the fourth floor.
Okay.
The entire floor.
It's the headquarters.
So this is a consistent ceiling height for the rack.
About 50 yards south of Independence Hall.
Okay.
PJ Clark's is across the street, right on Washington Square. It's I can assemble a pretty good sized block. In one section of it, I have 27 foot ceilings.
Now,
it's an older building, so you work with columns, but.
Yeah. How big is the space?
The first floor space is about 30,000 square feet, and I have some mezzanine levels that are another, I would say 15 maybe.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm.
So, 45,000 feet.
Yeah, we're not supposed to check it out.
It's a good area. I mean, I've got 600 Chestnut, you know, with Larry Steinberg, so I have that, the space next to Wawa.
Right, okay, yeah, I'm right down
Yeah, you're right there.
Yeah. The Curtis, there are apartments, you know, high-end apartments that were added there. So guys, this is a full wing, essentially. I could replicate this on the other side, and I could go up to the third floor as well.
Okay.
And building's a T-shape, so you have two wings.
Yeah.
This is kind of like finished office, but here's an example of what the column spacing is and the natural light is in here.
So this is the widest, and then this is the length.
Right.
Okay. So this is each floor, and then there's a little bit in the front.
Right.
Okay. I'm in City Line Ave, so I don't know, like 20, 30 minutes?
Okay, I can meet you there at 11 o'clock at that lunch.
See you then, buddy.
All right.
This one sucked. Looks cool as fuck from outside. But, it wasn't it.
For office space, but...
Aiden, what'd you think? You like it?
It's okay.
It's all right. What about you, Chris?
I already knew you didn't like it. Plus, when I looked at the ceilings, it was like,
all right.
Shit.
That's good.
Oh, all right.
I'm just kidding.
Just five words.
Right. I told Corey, I was like, he don't like it. Next thing you know, he's like, I'm not a fan of it.
What about you, Corey's content?
It's for more office space instead of a gym.
Yeah.
See, if relentless, when it pops off, yes. But...
Like what he said, when it pops off.
As is, we develop it ourselves. What's really important to us is with a cheap base rent.
Okay.
Usually we have a year to fit out, for good size. So we just ask for a year free rent, and then we ramp up on that. Our typical build out is about $100 a foot.
Obviously, this would be nothing like what you would need in here other than.
We tear everything out.
The ceilings, it's fully air conditioned.
Yeah. How old is the units?
They vary in age. They're all up on the roof.
What condition is the roof in?
It's all right. It's an older building, so it's not a brand new roof by any stretch. But
the TPO, EPDM, rubber.
It's an EPDM. So there's restrooms back here, as far as like access to plumbing and whatnot.
New parking spaces. You guys have 4,000.
We have 4 per 1,000 for this building. We'll go out back and take a look, you'll see. So right now, Lexus is parking like 240 cars there for the Women's US Open out in Lancaster. So
okay.
they're just storing cars here now for the time being, for the air conditioning.
Flex ducts.
Yep.
What was in here before?
The company called Megger, and they did light manufacturing and assembly of electrical motors and switchgear.
is marking the how much per square feet?
We are the Ashgear's $10 triple net. But you know, if you're talking about taking it as is, doing your own fit out, yeah, we can work with it. Oh. Megger moved out of here about a year ago.
You guys have represented him the whole time?
Yeah.
I'm assuming behind this wall is that 18,000 square feet?
Not this wall. I'll show you when we get next week.
We are
right here.
Yep. So that's that hallway.
Yeah.
And then on the other side of that is the 18.
Okay.
Which, if you want to see that, we can take a look at that too. So all of this, like across the back, would be you guys. If you wanted to have multiple entrances or however you
If we did a deal, we'd probably take all the space and Merkel's space.
Right.
Just so we can eliminate their parking.
Perks, yeah. So you could have the whole front.
Yeah.
Probably put out entrance on this side.
Can we make them go around the building?
Yeah.
Because we have a... I'll show you what our space looks like. We have a big outdoor component. So, kind of would need space for that.
So this is some of our facilities. This one's on Grand. This one's about 100,000 feet.
Oh, wow. So you put courts out back?
Ninja courts, outdoor gym, outdoor pool area.
Is it pool above ground?
Pool tables.
Oh, pool tables.
Here we would put a pool. So at the Neshaminy Mall, we're building two pools. We're building one inside, one outside. And that facility is going to be our biggest. That one will be about 500,000 square feet. This one's in Fairless Hills. This one's 75,000 inside and 125,000 square feet outside.
Is it monthly fee?
Yeah, this one is in South Philadelphia.
Very nice. Thank you. Maybe $1.60. I forget the exact breakdown.
Is this a REIT that owns this or like private?
This is private, two guys.
Yeah.
Bought it in August of 19.
Right before the big flood.
Yeah, right before the plague. Like this space that you're in now used to be occupied by Comcast.
Okay.
Comcast was here forever. They had all kinds of shit in here, electronic stuff, which is why they needed the air conditioning.
Yeah.
I think maybe this was like where they returned boxes or something. I don't know what the hell they were doing, but.
Cable boxes
on the dock
and
routers.
Yeah, but there's not much space in the front.
For what?
Parking.
But they'll be able to make it for
it. Yeah, I mean, how do you get in? You got to walk around or you got to build another entrance in the back?
Into.
Right?
What's that?
Like saying, so if we made the entrance here,
mm-hmm.
we probably have to build like a new facade so it doesn't look so ugly. Back. The front is nice, but there's not enough parking up there.
Right. Well, there's, depending on how you do it.
Yeah.
You have to put an entrance there. That wall doesn't need to be there. That's the light one. That's there.
Thank you, sir.
You run 40-yard dashes.
Not quite, he's fat.
Don't worry, talk all that because when you and Chris play pig, we'll put the whole thing on vlog.
Right,
please do.
We'll
get back to the gym.
Having a day.
What?
Hey, Chris, tell him what happened last time you had a fundraiser with me.
I'd rather not, but he won.
Faster than I look, okay?
I seen you run. And in the Shandy Mall. And that was an emergency run, I could tell.
That's what they want to hear.
Take it all.
Take it all.
And take it as is.
Oh, take it all as is.
It's music to their ears.
Fuck yes, where do we get this?
We're standing like right here.
Yeah.
So you could actually connect these.
Connect the spaces together.
I mean, the bathrooms you might have to leave for common for sure to pro, but I'm not entirely sure.
Hear what I said?
What?
It's a beautiful day to beat Tony Fusion once again.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, he won the last two games, so I'm not going
with you.
But, you know what I mean?
That's right.
With me, man, I'm undefeated.
Oh, you beat him?
Man.
What? He beat you?
When?
Remember, because I beat him. He's like, Chris, you're going to the next court. Yeah.
It's about what we all play.
No, I remember that.
Now you don't remember.
Yeah, I remember that. I remember that. You did get him out of here. It's cool. I'm gonna do it again.
And then the parking wraps all the way around.
Yeah. Shit is gorgeous.
I can see Chris in the ladder right now.
That's a right there.
Right. Me too. It'll get a lot easier though.
So this is common space, okay. And then it feeds the first floor, mm-hmm. over where we were just at, yeah. That, and then it feeds into the warehousing space. But this could be like the main entrance, right? Mm-hmm. And then all the parking could be there, and then the parking wraps around to the back where mm-hmm. we were.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you, Chris.
It's at ringside, man.
What a gentleman.
Yeah, that's right. Super ringside.
I didn't know.
And then this feeds right into that space that we were just at, right?
Yep.
Thank you, sir.
You have bathrooms there already, so you make 5,000, 6,000 square foot locker room, and you do the retail and you do the restaurant, and you got to walk through here. This is your parking, that's parking, and this is your outdoor gym and pool. The roof can't support it. Okay. Unless the roof's concrete, it's not. All right, sir. Pleasure.
Gentlemen, thank you very much. It was a pleasure meeting you.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Nice meeting you.
We'll
thank you,
sir.
Right. Thanks. Yeah, I'll call you.
I know what he said. You're gonna walk around. You got some ideas for it. So what you think, man?
I love it. You love
Did
it?
Did anybody do
the facade is what made it.
Yeah.
The front, so you gotta know how to show your own building. This guy doesn't even know how to show us the building. He shows us from the fucking random spaces. I'm like, yeah, man, so I'm like, oh, we have to build a new facade. Motherfucker, there's a big facade right there that's the main entrance.
Yeah.
Like, you gotta know how to show your space as a real estate. Yeah.
So, this all the space that we walk through, Fusion Works, coming soon. So like all that Mergo space, bro, co-working space.
Mm-hmm.
See what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
You can even set it up because we've got the training center.
Yeah.
Training staff there.
Yeah.
And
the university. Plus we can pick the space up for next to nothing because they're paying rent for a space they're not even occupying.
Yeah.
So whenever you're doing a sublease, you're essentially signing a deal with, let's say Chris signed, this is Chris's building and he's paying a lease. Chris's building, then if he's not occupying the space, he's still stuck in the lease, he's still paying for it. So then let's say Aiden comes in, Aiden's like, hey, I'll rent it for you. I know you're paying $12 a foot, I'll give you $8. So you're no longer losing $12 a foot, you're only losing $4.
Mm-hmm.
So you'll get a far better deal sometimes doing a sublease than a direct lease because they're underwater and they're paying it anyway.
Is there ever a case where you can get them like do a deal where it's like I'll buy you out to lease to take all of it? Or would that make sense? Or?
Well, I buy them,
you know, like,
buy the lease out for them.
Yeah, like I'll take over your rent.
Yeah, that's what we're going to do for Merkel, for this white space.
Okay.
So we're going to absorb their lease, but we're going to pay a fraction of their rent. Mm. Look at all this fucking parking, Corey.
Okay.
So people can park all along there, and you will walk across Africa to get into the gym.
Yeah, so you will cut
it's just
it off.
Like Lifetime.
You'll cut so it off, cut it off right, yellow.
Yeah. We'll cut it off right where the lines are.
Okay.
Where that red truck is. That's where the outdoor gym will begin.
All right.
And so then all of this will be parking.
That's boring.
They have 600 parking spaces, bro. So if someone ever says one per thousand, that means for every 1,000 square feet is one parking space. So if you do the math, there's 250,000 square feet here. Do the math.
Do the fucking math.
What he said.
I really like the co-working space.
Yes, it is.
Make money here, bro. Mm-hmm. Grab and go cafe. So we'll take it.
Leave all the Lexuses too.
Right.
No more reserved spaces. All right, it's open space for all of us.
Look.
Ooh.
Number two.
Yeah.
I come to work with an aggressive mindset, an offensive mindset.
Ooh. Okay.
I will own and resolve all guest problems.
Ooh.
I will create an environment. I will create memorable, unique, and experiences for our team and our staff.
Okay.
All right. Go. Go off.
I haven't studied all week. Pretty much, I gave the entire staff 1 week to study the principles. Paid time, an hour per day to study
you
the
got
principles.
Paid for that?
I said, literally, do it while you're at work. Take
I didn't
an hour.
Get paid.
So you just stand at the front and study.
That's bullshit. Bullshit.
Okay.
I didn't know.
You own the company, so she don't get paid at all. You're lucky I even pay you. Yeah, you're part of the company. change is the only thing that is consistent. You're either rising or you're falling, no one can float. Number two, I come to work with an offensive mindset. I am responsive to the expressed and unexpressed problems for any and all Fusion members.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on, wait. What's the opening line? Is come on.
These nuts.
I will create.
Yeah. No, it's not I will create.
Yeah.
No, it's, what's the third one, Aiden? How does it start? It starts with, yeah, I create memorable personal experiences for my Fusion family members as well as my team, and I build strong relationships and Fusion family members for life.
Yep.
Memorize those three in the last hour. Yeah, take that, take
we
that.
We got like eight more.
Yeah,
that boy.
Where is dude? Where are we at, Tony?
We are at the mansion on Main Street. It's my boy Chris's spot. It's a wedding venue. My little sister, my baby sister is getting married. So we're here looking at some beautiful, remind me guys, we're here looking at some beautiful venues for her wedding. She's running late, you know?
Hello.
Hello. Looks so nice. Did you guys already look inside?
Yes.
Oh my God. What do you think?
So,
you
like
it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Came here for a wedding before.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, you're about to be the best one. So this is my new brother-in-law. It's been my little bro for like, how old are you?
25 years.
25 and a half. I've known him literally since the day he was born. He's actually used to be our neighbor. My baby sister.
Aisha who?
It's my other little sister.
Let's go upstairs. Actually, you guys want to take the stairs, we'll go upstairs. So how many people are you guys thinking?
A lot.
Well, what's a lot to make sure we can even fit you guys? Because there's only a certain number we can. We are probably closer to like 320-ish, give or take.
Okay.
That's good, right?
I mean, it's a pretty tight.
320 is the max?
Yeah.
We go to 20.
Yeah, that's.
That's your biggest one?
Yeah. Cool. Gives us a limit.
Yeah, right? I know, right?
That's actually good. Because my parents are invited by 500.
I was just about to say. All right. So let's go do cocktail. So this.
I see this place get broke.
Nathan, I've been here the whole time. I'm ready for the rentals to be done. Luckily, everything inside's finished, so we're good. So this will be the main one. If you are Trudemark,
yeah. We'll
definitely have to use the overflow as well.
That's so the overflow, we'll just, and this is the main?
This is the main,
okay.
Yeah. Yep, and we'll discuss that too. Okay?
Cool.
Sounds good. So this is where the event will start, right? So with your desk out here.
Yeah, what do you think of that? What do you think of that for,
Yeah. Okay. We most likely would have to put some stations in here too with you being that size.
Gotcha.
This is just for food.
Yeah, this is just cocktail. Yeah, this would be your cocktail overflow. We're just using it right now for ceremony while we finish the reno in our ceremony space. Okay, and bathrooms are here too, so you guys don't have to worry about traveling from floor to floor, okay? So if you're good, let's head upstairs to have time.
I could just like chill here until like my entrance.
Yeah, of course, this is your room. Yeah. Yeah, and then if you need to be separate, we can have you on the second floor. Right. So we have something similar to this.
Okay. Ready to come dress?
Fancy.
This is the same one you were at. Yeah.
So if you want, why don't you come to the middle? We'll come over here so I can show you everything. So it is. All the desserts are over on this side of the space, and then we just run all the tables and chairs all the way through. DJ is here, so where that skirted table is. The two of you are situated here, center of the room. And then typically cake table, gift card box, and then we serve all the, I don't know if you can see them, but there's doors over there. We serve the food kind of from in and out. We never come through the middle of the space itself. And then we have uplighting, we've got spotlights, we have track lighting, so extra lights to kind of be part of the space, which is nice. So this is not set for its max, but tables of 12 ideally. So we provide tablecloths, chairs, napkins. If you guys want to do any upgraded stuff, of course that's fine. I don't have centerpieces, so that would be up to them as well. And that's pretty much it. Pretty easy. Yeah. Just show up and have a good time, more or less, you know? Do you have any questions up here?
No.
So from cocktail, so everybody will come in through the front doors, we'll escort everybody to the second floor, hang out there for the hour, and then everybody comes up here. Yeah, the whole entire event itself is a 5-hour event. If you want to add time, you guys can, which I can discuss with you too.
Yeah. So what time would that be? what's that time?
So with the size, we can do 2 weddings in a day, but we stagger them so that no one's running into each other. You guys can come through pictures, like that kind of stuff. Pretending I have every date open, you could typically start as late as 5, but because if you are looking for this year, we may have to do 4:30 is usually cocktail start time.
Do the food. What do you think, man? Like it?
Food is
oh, beautiful. It's beautiful, gorgeous. Really excited. I'm glad that we got a little head count. Give someone a limit. It's like, no. I want to see what's outside. Just for pictures and stuff like that.
Over here with your buffet, we're actually
going to
do a double-sided for you.
Just make her happy.
Make her happy. It's her favorite. We just out here sponsoring. Age size in this area?
Probably, okay. But we would get that for you guys. Because obviously we don't want it to take up too much
exactly.
Of your space for you. Yeah. But I can get you guys dimensions.
Yeah.
The biggest thing is all outside caterers, vendors, anything like that, they just have to have insurance. So just something, I'm sure they do. Yeah. But even for staging and stuff, so when that time comes, we can get dimensions and do all that stuff.
200, so we're like 320.
Yeah, and then your parents get involved and they probably can add people, right?
They are, the 200
man, they're family.
Is it really?
Yeah. Yeah. I have they all have.
And they have their own families, yeah, I get that.
It's crazy.
You want to go to Lucian's?
I don't mind checking it out.
Is there someone there that can show us around?
I would assume so. Okay. You would assume a call or I can call them on your way.
Yeah.
Sure.
My phone.
It's fine.
That's why I couldn't get a hold of you.
let's see the schedule here.
Yeah, and then we can also.
Yeah, I was going to say, you want me to check those 2 dates?
Yeah.
So it was 19 and 20. All right, hang tight for me, okay? I'll be right back.
No, hopefully she can do 18 and 10. I'm just telling you so that way you know before you go to the other place.
No.
These are
I'm
the
doing it for the scout, but for this one, I need it done. You can't have that stress.
No, but you should.
Okay,
Karen. Nah. Nah. Maybe a Young Love.
Young Love.
The outside is so pretty.
We saw it at nighttime and it was so pretty.
So during the daytime, it's
really
pretty.
Did you see
them
in the spring?
Yeah. The wedding was in August, right? The
one was in
September. September. So it's so pretty. Hello, friends. You look incredible.
Yeah, we'll go around.
easy. This mirror came in handy.
The other one is just like this?
No, this is bigger. 2 years ago. Was it 2 years ago or last year?
It was last year, September.
2 years.
Oh. 2 years?
Damn, it's been 2 years.
God, damn. How did the time go? It's crazy, man. You pulling up, Corey?
Hmm?
We gotta get you a Disney fit.
A what?
A brown outfit.
Oh yeah, I've been asking for...
Yeah.
Oh,
you gonna get one now.
You have to wear all
white. I'm also their other ceremony. Yeah. The one that's happening there, you have to wear white.
You have to. You like that. It's no choice.
Corey's at every event. He's at everything. He's more in everything than anyone else.
Cameraman. That's what they call you at the cruise.
My mom has a name.
Mom be like, cameraman, come here, dinner.
She's like, I can't
dinner,
remember
cameraman.
His name. I'm like, it's Corey, it starts with a C.
Yeah, right? It's cameraman.
Yeah. I think Tony said for that, his architect is supposed to come down and look at the spot for them to start doing the blueprints for everything so they can send it to the township.